Still in the underground temple, I presume.
Right, we all got teleported. Good. Oh man. That was crazy. Quick save. Hopefully there's no more surprises. Thank God. Oh! Oh my God. I go up.
Traveler, my heart does leap. To the crypt I'm glad to bring you, or the High Priest's office, if it please you. Traveler, my heart does leap.
My heart does leap? Oh, just a few, there's a shelf. Priest's office. Okay, we'll go to the priest's office.
Traveler, my heart does away, away, will fly away. A hurried choice is never.
Kind of like go in between these three areas anyway, so even if we choose the wrong portal, we can just go back. Face. Check this out too good, it's always useful. So much crap. Oh my God. Okay, this is obviously not the place we have to. Charmed. That's not here. So much of it. Oh no, there's a barrier. Shit, how do we get through? Oh, okay.
A pocket of serenity in the midst of such chaos.
This room must be woven with powerful protective magic.
A lot of loot here. Adventurer's Field Guide. Have I read that yet? Oh no, I haven't. Cool. Proof metal armor. Whoa. Give that to Roderick. Let's hope this one's good. Leadership to set chilled. Who needs a good sarong again? Firefly to Mebrium resistance. HP. HP seems to be more important than anything right now. HP, we'll give it to Madora. She's got Firefly. And we can use it indefinitely, I think. Yeah, look at this place. It's freaking crazy.
What's this? A blueprint for a so-called Sector of Command. There may be a way to handle these Death Knights yet.
Oh!
Scepter of Command. What do you think it's for?
From the look of these blueprints, It's got something to do with Death Knights. Perhaps there's a way to handle them yet.
Dude. Getting sick of their invulnerability bullshit. Undead Capitator, spellbook. What is that? An elven shield? Superior. ~21% blocking chance. 51. Immunity to crippled. Nah, she needs more HP. And I believe the main quest line is over here. Leandra's spell. And Leandra's lab notes.
Striking it rich!
Striking it rich. Where was the notes? Should be around here. There we go. Several fragmented notes, seemingly scribbled in distraction. Temibrium stores located within Lucula Mines. Devoted to conduit should expedite the mining process. Imp has proven useful in development of prototype, but the result was far more dangerous and difficult to control than anticipated. Talking about the Death Knights, the key is blood. Bloodstone in my own contribution of life. Make the resulting knights loyal to me in every way. Must be further midgetated. So that's why she's looking for this staff of command. Have developed method to make knights vulnerable if it should become necessary to dismantle them. Oh, okay. The spell and the blood suffice. First fully functioning prototype created, a beauty to behold, totally loyal to me. Immaculates will oversee continued production of knights. I expect that soon my army will be ready to march. Alright, so we got the spell. Not sure what that'll do for me, but... Until 1 HP.
A hurried choice is never wisest. Away, away, we fly away! To the crypt where ghosts lie sleeping! To the crypt with corpses weeping!
Okay. Plague. What is this? Plague. Plague. Can't really do anything about the rot right now, so we'll just get their health back up. Deal with it later, I guess. To heal these guys. Oh, there it is. Firefly's right there. She can use it. Dead end. Gotta go this way. Rests here into the source he has returned. To activate it. Where is Leandra's blood? Would be nice if you just like scratch her a little bit.
Hallowed be these crypts. Endeavor to worship or endeavor to depart.
Enter to depart.
Goddess, greetings, wanderer. What brings you to this house of the goddess during these troubled times?
I need to find Leandra's blood, you know.
A what? No, no, certainly not. I serve Astarte, our great goddess. A bishop of the source am I, in life and in death.
I am a source hunter, sworn to stamp out that disease power.
I ought to box your ears and tie your black tongue. A source hunter, you say? And what does your mission entail exactly? Chasing down the ill and wounded, healed by Source, and executing them? That's impossible. Absurd. Our Astarte is the great bringer of light, of order, of healing. No, I don't know what strange land you are from, Wanderer, or why you've come to her temple to spread such lies and gossip, but I think it best if you take your blasphemy elsewhere.
What is this temple?
The goddess's home, of course, her house of worship. Here she'll return when she's finished her great work. Yes, when she returns, she'll rejoin her beloved and loving flock here in this very temple.
Nothing about Leandra's blood, huh? Exteria, the entrance hall.
Away, away, we fly away. Quickly to the entrance hall. Come now.
Come now. We're just gonna have to move on. What's down here? That's where we have to go. What's up here then? Anything up here? Any goodies? Sort of looks like we can go up here. What is all this? Oh, I see. I don't see anything significant this way, though. Oh, we'll just go down. It's a cool looking angel. Flames, ornate chest. Give those stuff to Roderick. Dragon scale armor. What do we need? 9. Give it to Madura. Rapier of Hexing. 78 movement, water resistance, inflict poison on contact. Cool. Click visitor, and it's clear to go. This place is freaking dangerous. Pretty dangerous. Whoa! That one landed right on top of us. There's another mirror. Again. We gotta go back to Silver Glen as well to drop that Tenebrium ore to the king. It was an intro bounty,
armament.
To Brandon.
Soldier, soldier, burning bright. Where will you go? What will you see? The gold within? The sun above. Where will you go? What will you see?
I guess we'll go to gold. Sun above. Gold or sun. I don't know, man.
The gold within cannot be reached. My paths have all been mangled, breached. The gold within cannot be reached.
Okay, the sun then.
Prepare to bask beneath the sun. For your freedom you have won. I'll send you now. Hold fast your party. Goodbye, and blessed be Astarte.
Frickin' poems. Escape! Now we're back up again. I think Brandon's up here. Lawrence's office. Gotta get rid of all this timbrium. Brandon, where are you? There's just one guy here. There he is.
Oh no, pal of mine.
I need more lockpicks. Give me your lockpicks. Bang. Tough sarong? Let's discuss your retirement plans. Tell me more about the Troping.
You found the Tenebrium.
Yes, I have.
A grand feeling to have bested the King of Trolls, isn't it? Huh? Hand the blighted stuff over and you'll be privy to every damnable secret this place has been hoarding.
It's worth more than gold. We should keep it for ourselves. No, screw that. We got rot in the first place because of it.
That's right. I'm very interested to learn what Brandon has to share.
Six alive. I knew I could count on you. Now it's my turn to make good. I'll be happy to share with you the not-so-little secret of these mines.
At least they don't have that distinct underside of
a... Astartes, Source Hunter, you already know that this is a volatile material. What you might not know is that there are ways to handle it that can diminish or even prevent its negative effects.
Oh, my rot's gone.
What it takes is a little know-how. Here, I'll show you. And if you're ever looking for a full cure, I'd recommend visiting the Immaculate Chapel. Nod your way through their little sermons and they'll give you access to a special mineral that can heal even the worst cases of rot.
What? Bloodstone?
Now that there's a handy bit of information. But the real secret is yet to come, my friend. Lardance, the bloke from the mining guild, ordered dozens of men to extract tenebrium from these here mines, knowing full well that doing so was as good as sending them to their deaths. Beasts of burden, he called the miners. And said that the gilded turn a profit quicker if the men mined the stuff lickety-split before the rot ran its full course. I've got a letter here from the mining guild to Mr. Lawrence himself, proving everything I've claimed. You can have the damn thing. I've sat on this secret long enough. There, it's yours. I'm no man to refuse a source hunter. Ask a... Ah, those men. The first to perish, never the wiser until it was too late. There's a bit of guilt I'll take to me grave indeed. The Overseer's supposed to be something of a protector, if not a friend, you know? Well,
interesting. Tenebrium.
My liege, I am at your disposal. I am Lawrence, the representative of your grace. I never... Oh! Damn it all to hell in a handbasket. I can't do this anymore. Yeah, so the jig's up, eh? So what if I let those back-asswards yokels mine the tenebrium? I paid them well enough. And if they got sick, it's no one's fault but their own.
Well, it's your fault for putting them there.
I'll tell you what. You keep this little factoid between us, and I'll make it worth your while. How's... 1,000 gold sound. That's quite a heap of cash for nothing more than silence.
So much gold for such a small request. Count us in. Lawrence's crimes amount to murder. No amount of money can absolve him of responsibility. Okay.
Indeed. This free market is in dire need of some regulation.
Well, be a saint if you like. Not all of us have that luxury. Business is a dog-eat-dog world. I wouldn't expect you to have learned much about reality at your little Source Hunter Academy.
Oh, well.
Give me the strength, O Goddess, to become a Latin.
Oh,
Ready to advance, ready to defend.
The goddess is the word. Through the conduit she speaks, and through me, her wisdom is repeated. How may I enlighten you?
Read the words of the goddess.
Who are you?
I am Loic, enlightened one among immaculates, spokesman for the holy conduit, as she is spokesman for the goddess herself. Hers is the blood. Then it shall be my pleasure to answer them. We are the chosen ones of the goddess. The benedictions of the blood render our bodies and spirits unblemished, for such is her mercy that we may all become part of the sacred soul. And you too, Seeker, could become one such part.
No, I'm good.
The conduit, yes. She, the most exalted of all, second only to the goddess. It was she who brought us first her divine words, then her divine will, a will made real in blood. Truly, though, she is quite beyond your concern, O wandering soul. She stands so very high above your humble station. The goddess is the light and life of all. Corrupt is the world that generations of men and beasts have left behind, but immaculate it may be once more, cleansed in the blood of the unworthy. The few, the proud, the enlightened, theirs will be her kingdom. When red has run until no red is left, a paradise we will have shapen, and the goddess will dwell among us.
Let's discuss my joining to the Immaculate.
You find yourself in the goddess's temple. Therefore, it follows she wants you to take the true path. So here, have this hallowed tome. Read it. Absorb the wisdom within. Then find the second part and do with it the same. If an Immaculate you want to be, a test of knowledge shall be your first step towards enlightenment. Do you hold it to be true, Os, your unprepared...
Enlightenment. The initiation. Won't be able to join the Immaculates. Where's the book?
Diligently will I read the words of the goddess.
They would be saved.
Give me the strength, O goddess, to become enlightened.
Including the terrible rot. Well, we already knew that. How about we just kill these guys and, end the Immaculate Tyranny. Nothing but bad people.
That's enough for that! Yeah!
That's enough for that!
The miracles with which the blessed conduit rid our mean and mangled bodies of the rot that plagued it. Miracles we deem them no longer, no. Infinitely greater we now know them to be. Hey, stop that!
Stop that! How about I just keep attacking you, huh?
Hey, stop that!
God, save me! What happens when we kill them? Initiate.
She binds us in healing blood. She makes us whole again.
I don't think so. He's gonna die. Be interesting. Boom.
Some damage.
This guy's a level 10. Nice charm.
Happen.
They're weak. Boom. One more guy left. Now, I wonder what this is going to do. Terrible. Jelly room. Lucula portal temple key. Okay.
Got my Church eyes Hatch on key. The prize.
Tafra. Wait, what? Infiltrating the Immaculates. What could he be keeping there? Well, who knows? Let's go check what's underneath. Oh, there's a waypoint shrine.
A portal.
Shall we find out where it leads to?
Oh my God! Look at this, two bloodstones.
Treasure.
Well, I guess killing him wasn't so bad. One-handed. 42. Initiative. Who needs one? Leadership. Alrighty, yeah. Text notes. Let's read what that says. It details with much pomp and even more adjectives the method of turning a starstone into a bloodstone. First, the blood of the sacrificed is dripped onto the starstone. This creates bloodstone. Once the bloodstone has been used in the feat of healing, it reverts to its original state, starstone. Starstone, really? I've been using the bloodstone at least twice now, and I don't see any star stones at all. Time to check where this portal will take us.
Ah, oh, a peaceful wood. The caterwauling of cultists was making me ill.
Lucula seems fairly infested with immaculates.
Wow.
I wouldn't count on a long respite.
So it's a portal up here. Sacred stone. Base of operations. That's where we gotta go next. That's where we gotta go. Quite a bit of loot. Is there no other way? This is just a hill, so we have to go down this way. I want to explore this area as much as I can and get the most XP before heading into the Immaculate's base. So we'll go do that. Interesting. Oh.
Dear me, it is happening! The void, the darkness! Dear me, time lies in tatters!
Zigzags is back. What the hell's going on?
There's this place, this pit that lies to the north. It is a rift of chaos, an epicenter of a time and space devouring force. Void demons are besetting Rivalon, and the storms of chaos are shattering through our own dear homestead. Demons creep through the rift. They must all be destroyed.
If I'm to face demons, of course we need more information.
Not just any demons. Void demons. They are impervious to attacks with weapons or magic that any creature of this world can muster. But they have one weakness. For their simmering presence has permeated this area through and through for a long time. Tenebrium, that is the answer. The black ore that is dark as the void itself. Arm yourself with this foul material, and you shall be able to shred their bloodstone that controls their portal.
Well, that sucks, because I just got rid of them. What about the rift? How do I close it?
The rift is the portal through which the demons seep. There is blood magic at work here. And he who says blood magic says immaculates. A bloodstone fuels the rift. Obliterate it, and the rift shall close. I've scouted ahead a bit and seen that three paths, or what passes for paths, lead to the center of the wasteland that lies before you. To the left is an encampment of immaculates. Yes. They're but immaculates, but their weapons look sharp as shark's teeth. So don't barge in like cats at a dog's wedding.
Oh, we're gonna barge in.
The central path is a big no-no, too. Brimming with demons, I really wouldn't recommend it. Which leaves the right path, which may not be the right path at all, for it is deceptively calm along its trail and positively overflowing with magma.
Magma.
So basically, I can offer you three options, all of them as appetizing as pig feed. And yet you'll have to swallow your portion whole. If not, the end of time will be swept into the void and rivel on with it.
How can the void beasts that are here harm the homestead?
They exist beyond the normal continuum of time. They are here. And they are sweeping through the winds of chaos at the end of ages, shredding what they find. Unless they are defeated, your home away from home shall sink into the maelstrom of oblivion, piece by piece.
Piece by piece.
Do what you can, my friend. Do not falter. All depends on your prowess, and our homestead won't grow an inch until you've solved this dire matter.
Okay.
By the looks of things, it seems we're heading towards Hunter's Edge, the town where I was stationed before I met you, love. Before we get there, you should know the whole yarn. What I saw there. Why I fled. Yes, comrade. I fled a coward bearing the insignia of a sauce hunter.
The last you mentioned, orcs had invaded your village. Are you ready to continue your tale?
I think so, comrade. Even though you might never look at me the same way, I hope I won't lose you as compatriots. We, the villagers and myself, were corralled in the town square. The orcish queen sauntered into the middle, proud of the chaos she'd created. She screamed if we knew why they had come. Slowly, she approached me and leaned close, her hot, foul breath like fire on my face. With one hand, she clasped my throat. With the other, she reached into my pocket and pulled out the gem I'd taken from the orcs I'd killed earlier that day. I was a thief, she said. I'd taken something dear to her, and I had earned punishment. I thought she'd destroy me right then and there, but she did something worse. That's right, comrade, and I was soon to find out why. She brought forth one of her soldiers, a larger orc I'd never seen, and he was covered in black gleaming armor. She placed the stone in his chest plate, and something happened. He transformed into something I'll never forget. She made me watch as she sent villager after villager before the great transformed beast. He crushed them all, one by one, each more gruesomely than the last. He seemed to revel in the work. I could do nothing, comrade. I couldn't save them. I couldn't help them. I could only watch.
But you escaped, didn't you? You went to find reinforcements. Us! And we came to take the village back.
Don't you see it's already over? Don't you see it's too late? These orcs weren't out for riches or land. They only came for blood. No. All that's left in Hunter's Edge is a debt to be paid, comrade. And I intend to collect it.
Don't worry, we're heading that way. So this must be another zone. Whoa. Yep, we will check this place out once we finish with Lucula.